Yeah, if you keep hitting south, you'll hit the radiated wasteland, and I'll meet you there.
I love this rapier. Sorry, I'm trying to listen to you. I just launched this witch hunter like super high into the sky.
Oh. I see an ang golem.
What was it? What is that? It was launch. I think it's from the sapphire or something. Okay, but south, you say, yes?
Yes.
I think actually I could get my journey map back if I pulled it from the old mod pack.
Well,
but the problem is Twitch keeps making it read only. And so yes. It's like as soon as I open up Twitch or Twitch takes a second, it boom, pops it right back to read only. I'm like, why?
Well, I even had a thing coming up saying, oh, you need to be the administrator to let you do this. And it's like, well, I'm the only one that uses the computer. And I am the administrator. Administrator settings are on, but it still wouldn't let me do various stuff.
Oh, wow.
I am not heading south. I am heading west for some reason.
Well, hang on. I'm heading upward? there's these... The inventory pet.
Prince Zen. Leave me alone, Prince Zen.
Yeah, I need to find one because I have to kill a baron.
A who?
To a baron, like a super vampire.
A baron.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that one's empty.
So there's swampy. Oh, I've hit the wasteland. There's a swampy area next to the wasteland. Stay to the.
Oh, okay.
Stay to the. Oh, hang on.
Oh, I see you on the map. I'll be there shortly.
Stay away from this
chest. Turtle Mountain, can you fly yet?
Nope. No flying for me.
Not even gliding?
Nope.
Oh, you need to get one of the gliders. They're awesome.
He's a grounder.
What is this? What is this thing? There's a feral ghoul after me.
Feral ghoul?
A ghoul.
A ghoul.
Beastie.
So
which direction have you going then?
So if you stay sort of west of the irradiated area. And sort of head south. I can give you my current location if you want, Turtle.
I can look on the map in a second. I'm just clearing out these mobs that are everywhere.
Southwest of where you are right now. Is where I am, and I am radiated by 200 rats, even though I'm not in the wasteland.
Jeez, that's wasteland. Stay clear of that. I don't think my bat form can.
I think you, Giva, you want to go sort of a little bit more west. Otherwise, you're in the right direction.
Oh yeah, I see you on the map. God damn you. Quite far away.
It's sunrise. How close am I?
Oh, just stay in the retreat.
All day.
Dodge from tree to tree like some sort of lemur.
Wait, where are you? Am I close? I found the jungle. Am I
close? I've got a creeper. Hang on.
Yep, I found the village. I found the village. Haha! I think it's a village. Hello? Oh, pet shop owner.
That's the one.
Oh.
Pet shop?
I think I've overshot the village. Where am I?
If I bit you...
No.
I'm looking at the pet shop owner, I'm like, if I bite you... This guy's got a crown on his head. He's a crystallizer.
I'm in a mangrove.
I'm in a mangrove now, too.
Oh, there's the plague doctor stuff.
Yeah, so they're from the rats mod. and they've got a little house.
Like a hut?
Yeah. Which is full of animals in cages.
There's a rat trap.
North.
An effective classic. Okay. There is a pig totem.
Yeah, there's a bit of totemic in there. Well, there's totemic in the back.
Oh, no.
Hello, I am here. I have arrived.
Hi. I'm hiding.
As am I. Why is there a pig totem? What's going on with that thing?
Totemic. Do you know totemic?
No.
Hi, turtle melon.
Hello. You're hiding from the sun.
I was just hiding under the plum tree.
The sun is a deadly laser.
What, can I fly as a bat in the sun? Nope.
Why is there a silverwood tree here?
If this guy is a priest, I'm going to turn him into a vampire. Come here. This is an interesting place. Like, an interesting laid out.
Yeah, I think because it's right in the middle of some jungle, it's all a bit askew.
Ooh, got a tree tap and we got rubber sapling.
Hello!
Hello.
Would you like a brain?
Hey, wait, Gabriel, does this make you uncomfortable?
Well, you're actually hiding behind a shield, so no.
Actually, I really like the little shadow, like, dust effect around my feet.
Well, as long as it doesn't interfere with your own vision.
Yeah. No, I don't see anything at all.
That's good.
We got canola. I guess Gabriel's already got that whole farm going, though, don't you?
Yes. Is powering my machines, and yes, I cleared this building out.
You what?
I cleared this building out in particular.
Oh, did you? Can you grab the fermenting bill, bro? Nope.
Nope. Just breaks. Do you think we need? I know I've got some, but do you think we'll need rubber in the future?
I'm sure.
If you want to make 1,000 rubber chickens. We'll definitely.
Oh, yeah, we need to do that.
Gotta do that.
That's really an achievement. So.
Very high priority.
Yeah, 1,000 rubber chickens.
And the title is like, I don't know why anyone would do this.
Yes, but if it's possible.
Wait, have you guys looted everything in the whole town?
I left ages ago. I touched one chest and then went.
I might have looted everything in the town. Yes. I left the villagers. I thought the villagers would be more important for you. Do you want me to grab one?
To eat.
It's part.
Do you want me to
training.
Grab?
Never mind. I'm okay.
I have a golden lasso. Do you want me to grab a villager?
Yes, please. Give me a. Give me
an asteroid.
Lasso.
Would you like a pet shop earner or? Now, is it an asteroid or is it a meteorite?
I'm not sure. It's a big hole in the ground with a black hole.
It'd be a meteorite.
It seems
this guy's a hunter expert.
Because of my run speed, if I run into a new area and start attacking like a pig or something, it takes like 10 seconds before the pig takes any damage because the game's like, what the fuck?
Yeah, the game's basically trying to catch up with you.
Yeah.
Either pet shop owner or.
I haven't found a basic vanilla villager yet.
No.
And I think they're somebody that you definitely want.
Oh, here we go. Here's a villager from Minecraft right in here. He's a Fletcher.
Ah, yeah. trying to tame these parrots, but they're greedy little things.
Fat little fucker.
Yeah.
Right. Sorry, you gonna... Do you have that thing? That what? Lasso?
I do. Where are you? Hello.
There you go.
Who do you want? Take your choice. Yeah. Who do you want?
Oh. I'll take this, the Fletcher in here.
The Fletcher.
I'll have to name him.
Got him.
Are you auctioning him off humans?
I'm not auctioning. He's gonna just keep them. And
what about beetroot? Can I just
bleed them?
Oh, do you want to hang on to your lasso there, Trevor?
Yeah, I've got it. I've got him. I want a parrot. Sit. Come on.
Swear to God, chicken. Let me kill you. You need to feed my cheetah. I want a 64 stack of every meat just to feed my cheetah.
Yeah, well, that's if you have it in your inventory, like in your hotbar all the time.
I just will. The speed boost is so important. Like, for me at least.
Well,
so
I mean, I get it when I'm mining, but I'm going to take this guy. He's a hunter expert, Gabbro. And I'm going to make him into a thrall.
Okay. He's my bitch. Gonna make him my bitch.
Just for being an opposing faction. Alright, I need to find me another victim.
We've got two so far.
No, I mean a free roaming one.
Oh, okay.
So I can eat them.
So unfortunately, you can't eat the plague hunter.
No. If I attack him, it'll just hurt him. But this guy, the pet shop owner.
Have you been giving them a little nibble before you before you take them?
Well, I only have the one golden lasso.
Yeah, same here.
Unless you have like golden string on you.
Golden string?
Yeah, I'm
gold and string. Sorry. Yeah.
Yeah,
gold nugget.
At first, I thought it was like golden string. What?
Golden string. Yeah. No.
Golden string is actually a witchery thing that I've been doing recently.
Is it?
Oh yes, and there's a look. There's a thingy. A waystone.
Okay, so I've realised a slight bug with the speed thing. Sometimes it just doesn't turn off. It's on 0 seconds right now, and I've still got it, and I have them for like 30 seconds now, so that's pretty convenient. Sometimes I just don't even have to feed the cheetah. I'm basically just trying to like find the entire map, so it's like on my actual map I've discovered it all, so if there's any like villages or cool biomes.
Do you know that there's a feed bag you can have if you have multiple pets? And then you put all the different foods for all the different pets into one bag. And then you can have that bag in your inventory somewhere. And they'll just eat out of the bag.
That sounds very useful.
If you have multiple pets. Or if you have...
I have three pets.
Or if you have one pet. But you could just fill it up with the one food that one pet has.
So I could have more than one stack and it wouldn't take up one stack of my inventory.
Yes, exactly. What's this village capturing progress thing?
I'm capturing the village.
Okay. Well, it is slowly going up. Now, this is a vampire thing, isn't it? Capturing the village.
I think so.
Or is it a village mod? A separate village mob thing.
What? Oh!
I'm not 100% sure.
Oh no, Siren's got me. Oh, that was close. That was close. I shat myself then. Wow.
They're not friendly.
Yeah, I'm going to say, I was running by, my screen just turned pink.
Yeah, yeah. I love hats everywhere.
Good nice little ditty going on, but then, yeah.
They're all warm and inviting until they try to suck your blood.
It is taking a good minute here. Jeez.
What exactly are you doing?
I don't know. I'm capturing the village.
And am I able
what
to
that does, I don't
help
know.
In some way?
I don't know. I don't know if it'll actually help or hinder.
Vampires are camping and capturing this village.
Oh.
That's the thing I get when I look
at
the...
Yeah, if I hover over it, it says, yeah, vampires are capturing this village. The villagers actually came with pitchforks and attacked me.
Oh.
I killed them quickly. I was like, hey, I don't want to kill you.
Yeah, I want to keep you to eat you later.
Yeah. Well, we're almost done.
Melon.
Defender remaining. Are controlling this village.
Who is? What is? Vampires
are controlling. Vampires are controlling this village.
So
oh,
that,
look at this place!
That sets up some sort of faction thing. Oh, this
no.
is this is the pet shop.
I ran into oil.
Oh, and you're stuck in the oil?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my, wow!
It's awful, that, is it? It looks weird, doesn't it? All these animals in cages. We've got rabbits and cats in cages.
Apparently I've not eaten an apple yet.
What?
Have you eaten a melon?
No, I wouldn't mind.
Ooh,
if you
I just got two extra hearts from eating that melon.
I don't know if I can have any more. There's some more apples in here if you want, Gabriel. I've also not eaten a... Apparently, beetroots add rad resistance?
Yeah, I hired one the other day, and I was like, what?
And you know the sort of like,
loud in there.
You know the upgraded apples, like a golden apple or a golden carrot? Mm-hmm. They also remove radiation. Let me stick a waypoint.
Fuck off, sirens! She's dragging me in through the wall. Stop. Woman. She's putting me into a cave.
This guy's got red eyes now.
Oh, who? Where?
Oh.
Oh, this is so annoying. I can't fucking
get away. I need this guy.
Oh, he's a vampire villager. Vampire villager farmer.
Hey, don't you run.
So I'm officially fucked. So a siren's caught me, and I'm trapped against a wall, and I can't look away or move or anything.
Hey, whoa! Where did this vampire come from? Leave me alone. I'm on your side, surely. You might be able to do the slash home command if you can't physically move.
Well, if you can't move, yeah. But as soon as you move, you gotta restart.
No, that's happened to
now
me
before.
That's happened to me before with those sirens. They pull you towards something. And it just happens to be like a wall in between you and the sirens. So you're just face planting a wall. And you can't physically move anywhere.
I'm like, it's just drowning me. It's pulling me into a wall that's covered in water and I can't move.
Yeah. Yeah. That is a. I mean, it's a great sort of like concept of what the sirens do. But
my problem
with
is
it being
it should drag you towards them. It shouldn't lock your aim on them. It locks your mouse on them, so you can't dig or anything.
Yeah,
yeah. But you can teleport away if you do the slash home.
If I've set
command.
Up slash home,
oh, this guy is an actual vampire villager.
Well, you've converted the whole village, so they're all vampire villagers now.
Get out of here.
Whee.
Where'd the guy go?
He went inside.
He's just got me again.
He's here. He's here. Whoa, we've got bats. We've got vampires.
This guy's a sheepman alchemist. Vampire villager. Yeah, it's kind of funny. So I can't bite them anymore. The non-vampire guys I can bite. Hang on. I'm going to see if you got anything I want. Nope.
Are you still stuck, Turtle?
Yeah, I should be able to get out now, though, because I relogged and it put me in a better position. It's okay. So annoying, but I should be able to get out now.
That's good.
We've got more vampires coming. These are enemy vampires. Well,
they're not going to come after me.
Yeah, well, they're coming after me. These are your enemies as well, you know. They're trying to take...
they're here because...
No, they're trying to take the village back over.
No, I own the village. I'm a vampire.
Yeah, but these are vampires of a different ilk. they want to take over your vampire village. That's what these guys are coming for.
Like, this is a vampire village now, so we'll have it.
But there's different vampire clans, is what I'm saying.
No, there isn't.
Yeah, there is.
You're either a hunter, not a hunter, or a vampire, or a vampire. That's it.
Well, I'm not a hunter.
No, so you're a nothing.
You're a blood. Free prey.
Oh, yes, but they have much better trades now.
what was that?
Oil might be the worst thing in this mod pack. You get stuck in it, and it's just like, okay, I guess I'll sit here for half an hour and finally...
Hey, wait, Gavro, do you still have that other villager?
Yes, I do.
And can you pick up one of these guys instead? Like, maybe the Fletcher here. Wait, not the Fletcher.
Sorry, he's just closed the door on me.
Hang on, I'm going to bite this guy.
Ow! Oh, go! Get lost! Ooh!
There's a particular guy in here I want.
The one with the crown?
No. Oh, is it the turkey guy?
The one with the turkey?
No.
He's a pet shop owner. We've got a jam guy. We've got a pet shop owner. We've got a Fletcher. We've got two Fletchers.
Might be the guy with the crown.
And a crystallizer.
I can't see him, though, because there's other people in the way.
The crystallizer is... From actually
yeah,
addition.
Yeah, pick him up.
Hang on. There we go. Thank got you. Him.
Ooh. Got a good hat. So this is a good village for me now.
Well, you could probably do to clear out a few of these trees if you want to keep the village going. It's a bit overgrown.
Just a bit.
Okay, I finally made my way home.
Creeper! Creeper! That creeper! Adventure.
Well, yeah, that's pretty cool. I don't know if there's a...
I'm going to start starving to death.
Oh, I'm actually doing pretty well for food at the moment.
Yeah, well, you've been sucking on all these villagers.
Yeah. Oh, goodness. All right, so do we know what's farther south?
I don't think I went any further south than the village. But it looks a little swampy, if that makes a difference.
Well, I mean, it doesn't really matter to me. The only thing that matters is...
Well, we've got the irradiated wasteland still to the east. And then we've got swamps to the south.
Oh, wait. There's an upstairs to that one big house.
Fucking what the hell? I stopped for 2 seconds to eat and a creeper blows up right next to me straight away. Fuck's sake.
You want the creeper pet.
Yeah, I do actually.
That gives you immunity to explosions.
That's so good.
And then you can explode yourself if you wanted to.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Ah, vampire, go away.
That's, that and... I got some lava waders and I got an anvil pet.
The lava waders are so good.
Yeah, that was the only way I was able to actually survive in the nether.
Yeah, it is, honestly, because you have to just run across the lava to get anywhere.
Yeah. Well, it was mainly, I think more than anything else, it was the explosions, immunity to explosions, because of all the creepers that just lob TNT at you.
Yeah, them red ones.
Yeah.
I think I found a rat house.
Well, that's the pet shop.
No, I mean, there's nothing but rat stuff in the top. It's like rat tubes and rat seed and blocks of cheese and rat cages. Despite all my rage.
Hey, supply. Undermine just got an update.
Well, seeing as I am the only vampire, I think I should have a rat army as well.
Well, that's what I am planning to do, effectively.
Okay, well, we can have a friendly rat army.
Well, it's not so much a rat army, but you know the golems from Thorncraft?
Yeah.
The rats can effectively do a lot of that sort of stuff. You can have a lumberjack rat. You can have a
lumberjack rat.
Yes.
Oh.
I haven't sorted it out yet, but that's what I'm planning. But yeah, a lumberjack rat that'll go and cut down trees in a certain area, pick up the bits and put them in a chest. There's a rat that can do cooking for you. You can
you get the little chef hat.
Yeah, exactly. Or warrior rats, or attack rats. I'd like to see if I can do the rats. So they're part of like either cutting down the trees, putting them in a chest. Another rat comes along, picks it out of the chest, puts it into a furnace to cook the wood into charcoal. Then take the charcoal, maybe another rat. Take the charcoal over and put it into Britannia.
There you go.
To burn the wood to make mana. That's sort of what I'm hoping I can figure out and do. I'm not so bothered about having any sort of like attack rats, but if they can be my sort of like helper work, you know, take a load of work off my shoulders.
Right.
Yeah.
That's what
so
I'm looking
what
for.
What do these rats do? I missed part of that. You just use them to help you out?
Effectively, yeah.
You can, like, command them to do what you want sort of thing?
Yeah. Like the golems from Thorncraft.
Yeah.
You know, pick up stuff, move it to here, you know, put something in a furnace, make some food.
I'm guessing it's quite far down the chain before you get those, though.
I'm not sure. That's the bit I'm not quite sure about. But more actually being able to get the rats and then taming them. I think that's the problem.
Yeah.
That's the.
I know you stream Undermine. I don't know how much more Undermine you're planning on playing. But they just released an update, and one of the things they added in the update is there them blue chests you can find with the purple gems in them.
I'm sorry. Say that again.
Do you know in Undermine those blue chests you can find that have the purple gems in them?
Yeah.
They just released an update that makes them have 100% chance to drop an item blueprint now.
Ooh.
So you will always get new unlocks for finding one of those blue chests.
Oh, that's nice.
Like, that's an update I've been wanting for a really long time. I'm really glad they did that. Because when you've only got, like, 5 unlocks left, like I do, literally you can go 10 runs without ever getting one.
Yeah. Yeah.
Unless you pray to the RNG Jesus.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Make a sacrifice.
It does not favor me.
Hey, Chromia, how you doing? Yes, that was cheese. I don't know what Cursed Earth is for. It's not the normal.
Ooh, shit's gonna burn me along here.
Christmas themed Rat King film.
What do we have for storage? What are our options? We do have modular storage.
Yeah, you've got. There's an Ender IO. There's.
Modular storage actually doesn't need power, does it?
No.
I think you can
from
get away without
RL2, RF tools.
Yes. Like the storage scanner needs power, but I think like the modular storage and I think even the remote storage doesn't actually need it. You can also get the storage tablet.
As soon as I get enough redstone, I want to get those power cells from RF Tools.
Ooh, yeah, that'd be good.
Because they're...
Right, well, I'm going to get me a... They're I think I'm going to work on a modular storage right now. That's the storage cannon. I think I might have everything. So we definitely have that. We have that. What else do we need? Redstone, nether quartz, and lapis, gold nuggets, gold.
I missed my last base. My last server that I was on while I was doing Thorncraft, I planted a bunch of greatwood trees and made like a massive base inside all of the trees.
Oh yeah.
That was fucking great. I'm liking the setup though. I haven't done an underground base in a while.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello? Oh. Wait, don't
I brought you a king.
I don't want him to go anywhere yet.
Where do you want him?
Well, I gotta name him. So he doesn't disappear.
Do you have a name tag?
No.
I have not found a name tag yet, either.
You know what we could do? I guess pop down the other guy. I'll pick him up, because he had better trades. I'll keep him in my lasso, and if this guy just disappears, then he disappears.
He can offer me a human heart for 2 emeralds.
A human heart?
Do their trades change when
yes.
they become vampire villagers?
Yes. For sure. Okay.
Huh? Ooh, feathery wing. Oh, I can give that to the rats to make them fly.
What?
Flying, yep, flying rats.
What? That'll be the doom of us all, Garo. Okay, so we got that.
Oh, this obviously used to be a jam guy.
No, before... he's a pet shop.
Well, he's selling jam.
Hmm. I mean, well, you can see too, though. I mean, he's a vampire villager, but his career is the same. He's still a pet shop owner.
Where's the plague doctor gone?
I don't know.
Do you want to keep him at all? Shall I take
him
back?
Well, he's a rat guy. I'd rather chain this guy up.
Okay. Well, I'll take the plague doctor where he's gone.
Okay. He usually wanders around up here. There he is. Can I unchain him?
Yeah, but unfortunately, I think the chain sort of disappears.
Well, is it hard to make a chain?
No.
Is it like iron or something?
It's basically like a couple of iron ingots. If you turn them into nuggets, then you make like a chain link, and you want 5 chain links.
Oh, I see.
He gone.
Okay.
Sorry, did you want to trade with him?
No, it's fine. I've got to get into like the proper nitty gritty part of Thorncraft, and I'm like proper pushing it off and putting it off because it's really like, it's still enjoyable, but it's quite tedious. Like, you've set up Essentia pipes and getting the pipe set up and the valves and the different filters, and oh my god, it's so difficult to get it right.
I now have a chain thrall. Nice. My vampire prowess is growing.
Now, is he technically a thrall, or is he just some bloke that's chained up to a wall?
I think he's just some bloke that's now chained to the wall.
Oh, dude, I'm gonna put something in the Discord channel run right now. That's something I just got sent. Sec.
Oh, in Discord.
Yeah. Let me just save it. What are you doing, computer? Save the image. He's not liking this at all. Save image? No? Oh, there you go, finally. Right. Let's find the chat I'm working right now. There you go. So, like I said, I'm doing my Dungreed series today, right. Starting it today. And someone just made me this.
Nice. Very nice.
Indeed, it's so cute.
Can you change your skin in Dungreed?
I don't know if you can. You might be able to do custom skins. That'd be really cool if you can.
That would be pretty cool. I've seen that you can get different skins in the game, but I don't
you can,
know how you do.
Yeah, so they're not just skins, they're different characters.
Oh, I see.
Like, you can literally, like, you can be like a ninja who has like loads of extra dodge and speed, and then some people that have like extra armor and damage and stuff like that.
Okay.
But will you lose that character as soon as you die?
I don't think so. I think you can just select to play them. Like, I think you, once you get down to like the third or fourth floor, you unlock the ability to change your character. You find an NPC that allows you to change your character, like, whenever you want.
Okay. And effectively choose the same character each time.
Exactly. But I think the thing is, the default character is just default with no bonus stats. All the others have a positive stat and a negative stat, so they're not overpowered.
I see.
I don't think any of them are like better than the base character because they all have some downside.
Yeah.
Gabriel, do you have any redstone?
Yes.
Do you have 9?
Let me have a look how much I've got. I have 44. 70.
Can I have 7 of them?
You can.
It is almost. Oh, no, never mind. I got it.
There is an underground tunnel.
There is an underground tunnel, yeah.
My raven is just flying about with a golden nugget in its mouth.
Your raven?
Yes, I have a raven. Although he looks more like a magpie.
A magpie?
Yes. Yeah, they do, don't they? They do like magpies.
Well, this one in particular does.
I've seen a few of them about, and I think they do.
I mean, magpies and ravens are very close. The birth... Corvids. But this is it says it's a magpie, but he's got a white breast and shoulder plumage. And a red tail, weirdly enough.
Now you said too, Gabriel, that you think it was to the north, the vampire biome?
Yes. It was on a very small little island.
Island?
Yes. It was quite far to the north.
Hello. Is this the witchery?
You've not seen this little area.
Oh, so it is witchery. It's like a revamped witchery.
Yes. It's basically a rewrite of witchery.
Do you get to fight death?
There are mobs. There are you know, various demons and mobs and things that you do fight. Yes.
Okay, cool.
But I've basically
would it be
done...
alright if I stole like 8 gold?
What?
So offended.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, go on.
I appreciate your
preposterous request.
What?
How could you?
Yeah, go on. Go.
Okay, thank you. I love how you're saying, yeah, go ahead. And
you've already taken it. I know. Do you want the
like I left all my iron, all my ore, all my everything inside the chest that you just absorbed into your base?
Yeah, but there was like 5 of each.
What? No, it was not. It was
all right.
Not.
All right, 6.
All right, that's better.
Do you want this arcane workbench? By the way, I mean it's fine where it is if you want to use it.
I have one.
Oh, you have
but,
one.
Yeah, I have another one.
Right, because I'm basically not going to use it. So if you're not going to use this one, I'll get rid of it.
Ooh. Now, I'm pretty sure the tablet requires power, right?
Oh, what tablet?
I'm sorry, for RF tools?
Yes. I do have a capacitor bank with a battery in it.
Well, I'm just trying to think of a way to restore things. Kind of make it a little bit nicer. So that's why I haven't done very much mining and stuff like that, because I don't have anywhere to put anything.
But you can't put anything anywhere if you don't do mining to make things to put things into.
Well, no, I mean, you need wood to make chests, so...
Storing the stuff.
Woo! I always like to go like that.
But yeah, the enderpearls. Enderpearls are quite tricky to get hold of because the endermen are so scarce.
They've been like non-existent, really.
I think I've seen one, or maybe two at the tops.
I have seen a couple of them, but they have not been very.
Maybe we just have to go to the end.
Yeah, but how are you going to get to the end?
Yeah, that's the problem.
Well, the easiest way that I found, because I needed them a while back when I was asking you, just buy them from the shop.
Yeah.
They're not that expensive. That's what I did.
Yeah, but to get enough to make Ender Eyes to find the end portal.
Yeah, they would definitely get.
They're still going to be
They're like 150.
Oh, that's not that bad then.
I mean, at some point, I probably could start growing them with mystical craft.
I've got an ender lily as well. As soon as I'm get my golem started, my golem farm, I'm gonna set up an ender lily farm. The only thing is, they grow a lot faster on endstone. So
yeah, I mean, you can make endstone if you have like a couple pearls. You can put it in a smeltery and put it on stone. I mean, that makes endstone.
All right.
It is kind of a hard thing to come by, though. I mean, you have to have a couple. Basically, whatever you do, you're going to have a couple to start with.
Yeah, or if you get into mystical agriculture, you can make a load.
Yeah. So I have a weapon that's got the Enchant Vampire Slayer 3 on it.
Nice.
I don't know if that's a wise thing to have.
Slay yourself. Ooh.
Just don't nick yourself.
Yeah. Swing it. It's like, ah! Oh! Just kill over. Your hand slips on the handle and gets a blister and you're done. Because, like, some of these things I don't know if I even want. Like, some of these things I don't know if I even want. Let's see. I'll take all these things that actually stack out. Well, it definitely seems that the modular storage so far has been pretty nice. Okay, we'll put the non-stacking items in there.
It is quite sort of like a magic block system.
Yeah.
In that it's sort of like it's one box that does a lot of stuff.
Yeah, I don't know if these are worth using.
Let us stuff to dump. Stick stuff in there.
Okay, we'll put magic items in here.
I have some applied energistics in inscriber press things.
I think you can buy those from the shop as well.
If anybody wants them at some point. Usually sort of like to stay away from applied energistics.
Really?
Yeah.
I love applied energistics. I didn't like it when they made it so you couldn't... I think unfortunately what happened was when they added the whole channels thing, they lost a lot of the support.
Yeah. Well, I don't think I was really for it even before then, to be quite frank.
Yeah.
I understand it is a really good mod, but it's just a little bit too technical for me.
Yeah, I gotcha.
You know, refined storage.
Technicality. Refined storage is a little bit better, yeah.
Yeah, refined storage is really good. I do like that a lot, but I'd say the other one goes a little bit too far, but at the same time, it was there before refined storage, so it's you can't say it goes too far when it was there to start with. You see what I mean?
Yeah. Well, the thing with applied energistics too was that it wasn't always that bad. It wasn't until I don't know. It was a while.
Well, I mean, as far as I know, it never had. I mean, it worked. It never. If you knew how to work it, it worked really well.
Oh yeah.
It didn't have sort of like server crashing bugs, which I know for a fact refined storage definitely did at various points.
Yeah.
Well,
the problem with refined storage too is like they had a lot of bugs where it would just delete all your items.
Yeah.
And not just that,
but if somebody
it was just gone.
Yeah. But if somebody ran out of energy for their own refined storage system, it would not necessarily mess up, but it would just sort of like almost crash the whole server. Because one person
you're talking about like on Craft of Titans,
because one person didn't have enough energy to run the refined storage, it just messed up everybody else's, and everybody else like was down to
the
like
problem was it was
five
the,
frames
it was
a second.
Like turning on and off, on and off, on and off, on and
yes.
off. Yeah. That was what killed everything.
Yeah.
Because the server was just not able to cope with that. It's way too much going on all at once, so. Contaminated food. I don't know why I have those.
Ooh, I still have one parasite and cucumber sandwich.
Mm.
Yum 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 yum.
What a good mix. The classic.
I mean, maybe the cucumber helps to not realize what's in it, you know.
And even cucumber isn't even that flavorful, so.
Maybe you can pretend that the cucumber, like the parasite, just weird cucumber. I don't know.
Could maybe do with a little bit of chili on it as well, but you know.
Like chili? Like. What do you mean chili?
Chili pepper.
Chili powder, okay. See, I'm an American. Chili's different.
Yes, I had fish and chips earlier.
Oh, I had halloumi and chips. Damn good.
Okay. I was like, I don't know what those are.
You know what halloumi is? Halloumi is
amazing.
halloumi. It's like it's basically like fried cheese. It's great.
Oh, okay.
But the important question is, what are chips?
Oh. Well, so the problem is you guys call them crisps, chips, and chips. There's like three different versions. And it's
yeah,
confusing.
Well, now, Giver, it's two against one on what things are called. So.
It is.
That's right. You guys will always just be weird. No, I mean, on some things actually makes more sense, but I'm not gonna bend on the chips.
I mean, they're both made out of potato.
Yeah.
Unless you're talking Doritos.
Yeah, I don't exactly know what those are made
out of. Corn.
Well,
made out of
corn. Yeah, but it's not just corn.
Yeah, but it's not potato either.
No.
I mean, there might be some starch in there as well, but the starch comes from the corn.
Yeah. True. True, true. Well, there we go. I feel much better about my storage now. Oh, not yet. Hang on. I'll take it back.
I think I still need more ender pearls for any decent storage systems.
Well, I mean, I made that RF Tools one, and it's not like anything special, but it's better than having a ton of chests lying around.
Yeah. What are you saying? What are you implying?
I had a ton of chests lying around. I don't care what you had. I had a ton of chests.
Now it's all in one box.
Yep, now it's all in one box. I think you can even pick up the box too, so it's not like.
Well,
hey, who's making the injection chair?
Well, I just auto sorted one of my chests and it came up injection chair.
Oh, it's weird.
Ooh, I've just had a thought. There was something I was gonna do. And I was literally waiting to be on with somebody else when I did, I think this, is it that?
Let me see. He's going to kill us all.
No.
I don't know what you do.
Well, it didn't work. Whatever it was, it didn't work.
Ah, I need gold. Why is there no gold down here? Is there a better level to find gold?
You can actually search in JEI or NEI, whatever this is. You just type in gold.
Or you could make a scanner.
Or yeah. I guess
if you have any energy, any power, you can make a scanner, which will scan.
It looks like your best bet is at Y level 21.
21. Okay. Get away from my zombies.
And then you have a 17% chance of finding one. I'm not quite sure how the percentage things are calculated.
It must just be like an average taken from so many results, like sort of thing.
Well, I'm wondering if it's like you find an ore and you have a chance of that ore being something.
Maybe,
not like
yeah.
Every 100 blocks, 17 of those are gold.
But
yeah,
that,
when a chunk is generated sort of thing.
Yeah, that must be at the generation stage.
Yeah. So what am I on at the minute? I'm on...
Oh, do we have... 20,
did you say 26 it was, or 21?
Let me check.
Do we have RF Tools dimensions?
I'm thinking 20, 21.
We do.
20 has a slightly better chance, 18%. Or 0.18%, sorry.
We do. We can make our own dimensions. With RF Tools dimensions.
Your own dimensions.
Yeah, with RF Tools dimensions, you can literally change it so all the dirt is gold, or all the dirt is dimensional shards. It's very, very, very expensive power wise. The higher level.
And if your dimension runs out of power while you're in it, you are sunk.
Yeah. it starts sort of folding in on itself. So you've got to get out of there before the dimension collapses.
And if you don't, it starts like crushing you into oblivion.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I don't know what the deal is with sleeping, but I cannot make it 19.
Well, as I say, I'm guess maybe it's like you have to have more than, because there's three people on, you might have to have more than one vampire.
It doesn't even say so many people are sleeping, it's just...
I gotta say, that's what I mean, normally it'd say it, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gold is incredibly scarce right now.
Yeah, weirdly enough it is. But I have found more in the Nether than I have in the Overworld.
Oh, the Nether.
That's a very good idea, yeah.
But at the same time, what you find in the Nether is nuggets as opposed to ores. So you've still
got... There are some ores.
You've still got to mine a lot. You've still got to mine a lot of it, though.
True, true, true.
And most of my gold's been going towards making casts for various tinker stuff.
Yeah. Hi, Gabriel. Well, I'm gonna come say hi. What were you saying? There was like, there's something right next to you, Turtle Melon. Oh, spawner. That's it. Or spawner.
Yeah, yeah. There's like a double spawner you can use if you need to level up.
Going on an
adventure.
Well, I mean,
I'm level 41. I'm not hurting for levels.
I am level 15.
See, magic.
I have just received a chance cube.
Be careful where you place those. They can give some very, very big explosions.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. It's just a basic chance cube. It's not one of the big ones.
I spawned in a bunch of those and played around with them. You can get some crazy stuff from them. There's like some specific loot to those boxes, I'm pretty sure, that you can't get from anything else that are really overpowered.
Yes. Or you can basically get instantly obliterated by what it decides to do.
You're just as likely to get that too.
Yes. Which is why they're called chance cubes. It even gives...
When you open the map, it'd zoom in on where you are. Because I keep getting lost.
There is a little thing that tells you to follow where you are. But yeah, I think it should do it automatically when you open it.
I don't know. I think it's a version... This version of Journey Map does that. Where it doesn't automatically follow you for some reason. But later on, they do.
I got a submarine sandwich. Hello. I'll hit you with my sandwich.
Okay.
How come the nether portals keep getting destroyed? I keep going through my nether portal and it creates a new...
Oh.
That's weird.
Well, so long as it doesn't do it on the way back. And then it just makes a nether portal somewhere in the middle of your base.
Yeah. So,
I've got something to show you.
Oh, jeez.
No. What happened there?
It's like teleported across the screen. I was like, what?
I've got something to show you.
Okay, hang on. Let me put my armor back on.
It's not that bad. And look, it's sunset, so you'll be fine.
Oh, are you talking about the chance cube?
Nope. I have an egg.
An egg?
I laid an egg.
Is it the golden egg?
It is.
Yeah. You have a little mini use that creates chaos?
Maybe. I'll put him on top of my...
What is this?
Oh, this is where I've been making... This is my charcoal kiln.
Oh, okay.
I'll put him up there. And then we'll stand back. It might break a few
blocks.
Don't
you have to touch it?
Oh, maybe.
Or did you sit on it? I don't really remember.
I think I warmed it up. There we go, it's moving.
Oh, there we go, it's turning.
Turn it. It's a moving.
Whee!
She's spinning.
Oh god, bust it out.
Ooh. That's quite a light show. Ah!
Don't look! Look away!
Oh, don't look if you're susceptible to flashing lights.
What the hell's going on?
It's a mini
camera! Oh, look at him! Look
at
him!
A mini you?
Oh, he's so cute. Hello. Oh, you do? Ow! Hey, do you mind? I'm bonding with my child. Do you mind? Feeding skeletons. Where's he gone? Oh, he's run off. Like father, like son, he's just run. He's just run away.
Wait, what is this?
What? Don't break it. Don't break my beanstalk.
Does it go to another dimension?
No. It just goes very high up.
Beanstalk that goes to another dimension. Oh, I'm dead.
Oh.
Oh no! What the hell? Okay, I fell in lava and took like 2 damage. I fell from really high up there.
That was this beanstalk is my platform for using my hang glider to go to distant areas. Oh,
so you said that Vampire Island's to the north.
Yes. I think it was quite far to the north as well. Why do you want Vampire Island? Why do you need Vampire Island?
I need to kill him.
All right, there was nobody there. It was as I say, it was a very small island.
I'm getting this weird hub.
I think the server's crashed because I can't eat or anything.
Somebody might be loading new.
It might be me. I mean, I don't know how far.
I can do everything else. I just can't eat.
Are you hungry?
Yeah. Oh, there you go, finally. It just wouldn't let me.
Just be careful of the serpents and the water monsters.
Sorry, yeah, I was flying on a hang glider.
Oh, is that a tower right next to you?
Oh, balls. Yeah. All of our markers are gone, aren't they?
Yes.
I might be quite lost.
Did you set your home spawn?
Nope.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, you might be lost.
Right, I'm going to run back the way I think is maybe home. I'm probably very lost.
All right. There's the tower guardian.
Mm-hmm.
Do not kill him until you have taken the loot. That's the.
I took what he dropped, but yeah, I'm not interested in actually fighting him. I don't know how far you are from me.
Well, as I say, I don't have.
There's a pixie village.
I don't have the map anymore. I mean, assuming the map is the same as it was.
Yes, it would be the same.
It should be the same. I'll see what I can do. Now, this is very dangerous for me, because I am not a vampire.
Oh, what is that? You're like a brown mage. Hello?
A brown mage.
Yeah, he's an evil one.
Does he have the power of the brown noise?
The brown note?
Ooh, I'm in water. Oh, what on earth happened? There's a water beast.
A beastie.
Beastie. A big long serpenty beastie.
So yeah, I'm incredibly lost.
I'll see if I can see you on the map.
Oh wait, are you in the Nether?
I'm in the Nether and forgot that all our markers are gone.
Oh, well, I can't help them. Ooh, there's a wall.
Like, I'm so disorientated now, I have literally no idea. Right, my only plan now is find the obsidian totems and make myself a new portal, but I'm going to be thousands of blocks away, though.
Yeah. Possibly.
Alright, have I gone too far, Gabbro?
Probably not. It was a long way. But at the same time, because I have no map reference anymore. It's hard to say.
Was it like straight north though?
Maybe. I just went for a long journey. And it was roughly north. I was sort of island hopping.
Roughly north, okay.
Yeah, and I am flying over lots of terrain at the moment and nothing is showing up. It's just
void. Okay, I can't even mine the obsidian. It just comes straight back when I mine it. Like, the fucking blocks here are bugged.
I think it's the server's not happy.
That's,
generating too many chunks.
Yeah, both of us.
I can't do anything. I'm basically fucked. I can't get out.
Oh, I've already gone past you.
Oh.
Hello.
Some very dark clouds.
Very dark clouds. Oh, what was that?
Very windy.
Very windy. I don't remember all this snow. Tell you what, I'm gonna go back home and then see if I can help Turtle.
Sounds like a good idea.
You'll be fine. Don't worry.
I've made some progress. I found the Nether Fortress again. But I think this is the right one anyways.
I've just teleported into solid stone.
Okay, I found the Nether Portal again.
I am stuck.
But I don't know which direction home is.
I am stuck.
Ugh. I forgot that I had another chest full of stuff.
Are you alright, Turtle? Or do you need...
I'm not sure yet. I'll give me like 2 minutes to see if I can find my way back, because I think I'm heading in the right direction now. But I can't be sure until I've gone over this hill.
I mean, the main problem in the Nether is that you don't know whether you're too high or too low, even if you have found the rough area that you started at.
Yeah.
There's even less indication.
Hello, Rudolph.
Rudolph.
Oh, stop attacking me! I'm trying to find my way home.
You follow Rudolph home. He might tell you where Santa lives.
Okay, I recognize. Actually, not only do I recognize where I found the blocks that I built, so I'm definitely in the right direction. Oh, cool, I found a tunnel that leads the way back, I think. Thank me for building a tunnel.
I think Turtle Melon went kind of nuts with tunnels.
I did. There's lots of tunnels in here.
It's the only way to survive in the Nether. With all those mobs.
Okay, I've lost. I see you. I'm very close to you, Nick.
Me?
Oh yes, I found my staircase. Oh, I am a beast.
I was gonna say I thought my client had crashed.
Yes, I found my way back.
Oh, hello.
Right, let's get a marker on this bitch.
This one is my portal.
Yeah, I have to go through that one now. Mine got destroyed somehow.
Yeah, this is very bad.
Maybe because my portal was a bit too close.
Right, I still need more gold.
What has happened?
What?
I don't know what has happened.
I don't know what's going on.
You're being attacked by something. He's in some snowy biome.
No.
And the sun's coming up.
Yep.
A wizard spider.
What was that?
A wizard spider. I have no idea what that is.
I only died like 2,000 blocks away from home.
Oh my god, the fucking Nether animals are the worst.
It's gonna take me all night to get there again. I'm just gonna go to bed in my coffin. Wake me up when it's nighttime. Well, there you go. Speaking of the devil, it's nighttime. It worked that time. Oh, it's because you guys are in the Nether, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah. It must be that then. It must be that.
See, what would be a good little device would be like a small dimension that one person can go in. That, you know, access through a block, and then somebody else can pick up that block and move it somewhere else. And when the person inside the dimension comes out of that dimension, they are where the block was placed.
Yeah. We're pretty cool that.
Well, you can kind of do that with planning logistics.
Well, we don't have the means to do it at the moment.
No.
Or compact machines. You might be able to do that with compact machines.
Yeah, compact machines, yeah.
That's
no, actually you can't, because it stores where you were.
Hey,
why
hey,
can
hey!
I not move.
Do you mind you?
Like my control, my keyboard's breaking out. Switching.
Scary and annoying thing with using vein miner or ore extraction. And accidentally hold it for just a fraction too long, and then you start vein mining the netherrack.
Yep.
And you just
potentially. So much durability.
But at the same time, it does it so quickly, you can't stop yourself. Yep. And you could potentially just fall into oblivion or lava.
I did it earlier, and tons of pickaxe durability, because I mined like hundreds of blocks by accident. Right, I got a lot of gold there. I got 564 stacks of nuggets. And I got myself a blaze pet.
Ooh.
Strength on extra strength, so deal extra damage and fire on all of my attacks.
Ooh, that's good. Actually, you know, honestly, I don't care so much about fire on attacks because
the only reason
light
I care about it
fire.
Is for cooking meat. Like, oh. Although it might be kind of a pain actually for cooked that because I need uncooked meat.
Oh yeah, you need uncooked meat. Yeah.
So I'll have to see how that works.
Well, I usually don't like it because if I hit something and it doesn't die right away, it's on fire, and then it'll hit me, and then now I'm on fire.
True.
And so I usually don't care for them too much, but... It's about 800 blocks away from my death. No, so I walked up to this weird thing, and there's a chest, and I walked too close to it, and all of a sudden it said, boom, and I got the achievement enshrined, and there's these four brown wizards that popped into existence, and then they got me stuck, and I hit the wall, and I got completely frozen. I couldn't move at all, and I got picked to death by little baby spiders.
Yeah. Ow. Not the best way to go.
No.
Certainly not. Is there any items in any of these mods make your hotbar bigger? They give you like a double hotbar? Because I know some mods have that.
Not
I think Tinker's Construct has that.
But it's sort of like a secondary one. You have to press a button to access it.
Just because I think for my pets to work, I have to have them on the actual toolbar. Because I just noticed when I got the Blaze pet, you have to have it on your toolbar for it to work.
Okay, great. I am stuck again.
Yeah, you do have to have it on your toolbar for it to...
So at the minute, I've got three toolbar slots just gone.
Wizard Spider fell from a high place.
Yeah.
Is Wizard Spider someone in the server now?
Yeah. Well, I don't know why it came up. Wizard Spider was slain by Giva using Giva's Raper. Twice.
Raper?
Rapier. I knew somebody whose last name was Raper. I went to school with somebody whose last name was Raper.
Oh,
and his father was a butcher.
Damn.
but yes, you do need the pets on your hotbar. Now, if you have a secondary hotbar through Tinkers, or another mod. I don't know if it still works as an active hotbar sort of thing.
Well, I am never going after one of these things ever again.
There is also a inventory upgrade, which will give you more space in your basic inventory.
Is that Tinkers as well?
No, that's in Cyclic. But at the same time, I think it's another little tab that you have to click, or a key press, or a hotkey to switch over to it. And again, I don't know if it'll work as sort of like an active thing. But I think the thing you might be looking for is the tool belt from Tinkers.
Yeah, because you could swap your...
But again, like I say, it's you need to press a hotkey to activate it. So I don't know if you have all your pets in a secondary hotbar, whether they will still be active constantly if you're in the basic hotbar.
Mm-hmm.
If that makes sense.
Oh, I don't think so. It has to be your main hotbar, I think.
Because yes, that would be very useful. If you literally had the tool belt full of inventory pets, all active.
Yeah.
But you're not actively selecting them. But they're still active themselves. That would be really useful. But I don't know if it works that way. It's worth testing, for sure.
Well, so Gabbro, real quick, did you go through a snow biome? Before you found that vampire.
Well, I went island hopping, and I went to the west, and then to the north, and then sort of like curved back round to the east. So, well, look, all I had was the slime sling and a the glider.
Ooh,
I didn't have flying ability. And do you remember Turtle earlier when I was saying I was being attacked by some sort of flying fish dragon thing?
Yeah.
That was on that sort of like loop around that I was when I was exploring.
Wait, you were getting attacked by a what?
Yeah, I have no idea what it was. it was attacking me so quick I couldn't actually identify what it was called. But I definitely got a few screenshots of it. But unfortunately, Twitch being Twitch, has deleted all of them. Because it deleted my instance, therefore it deleted all the screenshots I've taken. But yeah, it was this weird thing. It was like half dragon, half fish-like thing. But it was flying, and it was dive bombing me constantly, and then also spitting acid at me, or some sort of poison.
Oh yeah. I think it's a fire and ice one.
I think it was, but it was basically doing very little damage to me. But at the same time, I could do very little damage to it because it was so quick, and I didn't have any long range. I didn't have bow and arrow or anything like that, so it was. I couldn't get it very easily.
I found some peck. Quick.
Pecky, 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 pecky. I also caught a...
make a chain. Make a chain for the peck.
I can lead him with gold. It's fine. I should be able to at least. I've got quite a lot now.
Can you catch one in a soul vial?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no. You must be able to do that at least.
Dude, peck. Look at the gold I'm throwing on the floor and what? Come after it. Oh, the most annoying thing happened. So, do you know this spawner I was just telling you about? When I first found that, there was like four peck in there. And then they all started fighting a skeleton and two of them died. So then I was like, okay, for fuck's sake. And I got another two of them and I got them with gold nuggets all the way to my base. I locked them in the room. And literally, so I just built this like blast furnace thing with Thorncraft. And you've got to put stuff in the top. So I made like a little staircase to get to the top of it and put it right in the back of the base. And I shut the door and I put the peck in and both of them immediately ran straight to the furnace and jumped in the lava. Commit suicide immediately.
Wow. They're like, nope.
Literally, yeah. It's sort of like,
we know what he's going to do. We know where we're going planned.
It's like, yeah, as soon as it was like, fuck it. I chased one in, because one of them I got back and he was already gone, so that it must have been what he did. And the second one, I got in, I chased him in, and I just watched him just jump straight in. There's nothing I could do.